السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Welcome back dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to our course Madina Maktub. Inshallah, in today's class, class number 18, we're going to first of all do certain vocabulary and learn some words which we used in the previous lesson. So this is just a singular and plural words. Miknasatum means a broom and jamu is makanisu. If you look at the pattern here, it is mafailu. So this is a dip boat. So this has a particular name which we'll learn later on. It's called mafailu. So it's a certain name. Sullaman is stairs. And jamu is salalimu, means it is plural for staircases. So again the same pattern, salalimu is mafailu. Manaratun is like a minaret and jamu is manairu. And same thing like mafailu, manadilu, it's the same pattern. Nazaratun is glasses, like spectacles, and jamu is nazaratun. Is a nazaratun. What is the pattern here? It is jama mu'annas salim. Nazaratun and nazaratun. We have ajalatun means wheel. Ajalatun means wheel. And jama is ajalun. Jama is ajalun. Lihyatun. Lihyatun means beard. Lihyatun is beard. Lihyun is plural for beards. And Suratun, this is with swan, swan, waw, rata is means picture, and suwarun is pictures, plural, suratun and suwarun, whereas suratun with scene is chapter in the Quran, suratun, like any surah Fatiha, surah Nas, and this is all with scene. That's why it's very important to have correct pronunciation and correct understanding of the letters. Suwarun and suratun, and the both the plural is suwarun. Iza'atun. Iza'atun means a radio station and jama is iza'atun. Iza'atun, so it is same jama mu'annas salim pattern. And then we have aarin, so it is aaliyun, but as we know, ya is a naqis word, it's a weak word letter, so that is dropped and as compensatory kasra is again, it is aalin. And muannas, when ya comes becomes visible when another letter is attached, that is if thamar buddha is attached, then ya becomes visible, is because aaliyatun is high. Aalin means high and aaliyatun is high. Muannas. So this is the vocabulary. Sabun, this is what the same word is used in Urdu. Sabun means soap. And albarihata, albarihata means yesterday, same like ams. And mulawwanan, mulawwanan is colored. It comes from the root word is laun. And asiyun, asiyun means juice. And we got burtuqalan is orange. And sabahun, sabahun is morning. Kuratul qadami is your football. Qadam means football. Is kuratul, kuratul qadami is football. And kuratul sallati is basketball. Sallati means basket. Kuratul sallati. And nisfun is half. Nisfun is. So going to next session, we're going to revise what is a mudaf and mudaf ilahi. So we've learned before, it is an idafa, which means we are giving a connection, and it is a connection or relationship of possession where there is an owner and a thing which is owned. So the mudaf is the thing which is owned, and mudaf ilahi is the owner of the thing. So this is the basic relationship which we have learned before. For example, if you see here Rasulullah, so here if you see mudaf المضاف إليه they have a relationship and as we know مضاف cannot have al and it cannot have تنوين okay so it cannot even if it is definite it cannot have al even if it is indefinite we cannot have تنوين so we know the sign of definite is al and sign of indefinite is تنوين but مضاف it cannot have any of those signs of definite or indefinite so how do we know that this مضاف in a sentence is definite or indefinite so what do we look for مضاف إليه so if the مضاف إليه is definite then the مضاف is also definite so if you look here Rasulullah so Allah is a definite noun so that's why then the Rasul also become a definite so it's particular messenger so Baytullah the house of Allah and here in this segment if you see Allah is the owner of the house which is Bayt Mudaf and which is Baytul Mudaf and Allah the word Allah is Bayt Mudaf ilahi and Fitnatul Insani Fitnatul is Mudaf and Al Insani and Mudaf ilahi can have Al and can have Tanween so if you see in this example here if you see Nuru Mu'minin so if you see here in all these three segments here Nurul Mu'mini and Nurul Ardi so what is the difference here we look at the first Nuru Mu'minin here the relationship is definite but the Mudaf is indefinite because Mu'minin is an indefinite it is having the mean and it is a sign of indefinite it is the light of a believer but if you see Nurul Mu'mini the light of the believer it is talking about the specific Al-Mu'mini we know when Al comes it cannot be Tanween and because Mudaf is always Majroor it can have only Kasra so Nurul Mu'mini so in this here Nuru is also definite because Mudaf is definite and Nurul Ardi is the light of the earth it is also definite because it is Al Ardi it is a definite noun and another example here Libasul Waladi Libasu is cloth of the boy so that Libas becomes a definite because the boy is definite if say Libasu Bintin okay so here the cloth of a daughter Bintin is a daughter so if it is Al Binti is the daughter so then here it is indefinite because you can see it is ending with Tanween so what is Libasun Jadidun is this Mudaf Mudaf Ilahi no because if you see here Mudaf Ilahi is always Majroor so it's a tricky here so we need to be very sharp and realize that this is a relationship of Naat Man'oos because they both have a similar case endings and similar characteristics Libasun Jadidun so it will be translated as new cloth So that's the relationship of Mudaf, Mudaf Ilahi. This is the Mudaf Ilahi is the owner of Mudaf. However, in certain, there's always an exception. And the exception is that when we say in Quran, Rabbun Nasi, which is the Lord of mankind. So here, Rabb, the word Rabb is Mudaf and An-Nasi is Mudaf Ilahi. Here Mudaf Ilahi is not the possessor, not the owner of Rabb. So here because Allah is the absolute owner of everything, so that exception, that rule does not apply here. Rabbun Nasi, like Malikun Nasi, King of mankind, Ilahin Nasi, it's the God of mankind. So here that Mudaf is actually the absolute owner of the mankind. So here that rule does not apply as normally we say Kitabullahi, the Allah is the owner of the book whereas Malikun Nasi so Nasi is not owner of Allah it is the other way around is the Allah is the owner of the mankind it gives because it switches around so it gives like a very very deep emphatic meaning so going to go forward مضاف مضاف إليه يسمونه zoom is special مضاف. It always comes as مضاف because in its meaning it has of built in, which is possessor of. Okay, so where was zoom comes? Zoom, this means this is a possessor and it always comes as a مضاف and there is always a مضاف إليه which comes after it. So what is the feminine version? This is zoom is used for the masculine nouns and ذات is used, it's the same meaning but it is used for مؤنث nouns. So we're going to answer the, it has the same مضاف مضاف إليه pattern. So what we're going to do is inshallah we're going to do certain examples so we can understand the use of the word zoom as a special مضاف and مضاف إليه. So أين الكتاب, so أين is ظرف. We're going to learn more about this later. It is a ظرف and if you can understand what is happening here is every sentence we know we got a مبتدا and خبر and here and we know ظرف is like a شبه جملة and like جار مر شبه جملة can never be a مبتدا. So أين is also not a مبتدا. So where is مبتدا? We have الكتاب. So مبتدا is definite and it has دمة. So الكتاب is مبتدا and zoom is coming as a نعت for الكتاب which is the كتاب which possesses. What does it possess? الغلافي. الغلافي is a مضاف إليه for ذو and الأحمر is again it is a نعت for غلاف. غلاف means is a cover. So if you understand this, the book which has a red cover. Okay, and أين is actually your خبر. خبر مقدم. So but it is a particle of question, so it will have a question mark. So where is the book having red cover? أين الكتاب ذو الغلاف الأحمر. We say لمن, again same thing here. لمن is جار مبني بدون خبر مقدم. ذاك, ذاك means short form for ذلك. So we know after that is a اسم الإشارة للبعيد. What comes after اسم الإشارة is your بدل and بدل always represent مبدل منه because ذاك is مبتدا it's مرفوع. البيت is also مرفوع. So to whom does this house belong and what does that house has? ذو. That house is the quality of ذو and possessing and having بابي. So after ذو we have مضاف إليه البابي الأخضري. الأخضري is green. So to whom does this house belong which has a green door? من ذلك. ذاك and ذلك they are both same. So من ذلك الفتى. So again من ذلك الفتى means young boy. So it is coming after اسم الإشارة with ال. So it is بدل. So ذلك is مبدل منه. ذو النظارة who is having a glasses. نظارة is a spectacles or glasses. ذلك الرجل. ذلك is مبتدا الرجل is بدل. ذو اللحية having لحية is beard and what is الطويلة is not. So we will translate الطويلة first. So who is this man with tall beard? So who is it, that man who has long or tall beard. Long beard is the tabibun, is doctor. Mashhurun, see tabibun mashhurun again not for tabibun, is famous doctor. Min Pakistana. In Pakistan, from Pakistan. So again certain examples here. من ذلك الولد. So depending on what noun is coming, because it is a مذكر, so we use ذو. ذو الخميس. So who has الخميس الأحمر having red shirt. So who is that boy having red shirt? ذلك الفتى. So that young boy. ذو الشعر. شعر means hair. شعر means hair and الطويل means long. So who has long hairs is طالب من إيران. happening in Iran. So liman hada, see liman, to whom does it belong? Hada daftaru. So you say hada daftaru zil ghilafi jamil, with beautiful cover, having a beautiful cover. Zalika rajul zun nazarati mudiruna. So that man who's having glasses is our headmaster. Min zalika rajul zun lihyati al-qasir. So who is that man who is having a short beard? So what is the answer? Huwa muadhinun masjiduna. Huwa muadhinun muadhinu masjidina. So what is happening here? Huwa is mubtada, muadhinu is your khabar, wa huwa mudaf, and masjidi is mudaf ilayhi, and if it's a single kasra, which means again it is turning into mudaf, wa huwa mudaf again, and na is your mudaf ilayhi, he is muadhin of our masjid. So this is how we use zu. So coming to the feminine version, which is dhatu. So we just do certain examples so we know how this, the these nouns which are used, zu and zatu. So ayn al majallatu, see, noun with tamar bota, it is feminine. We say zatu suwaril mulawwanati. So where is the magazine that has colored pictures? Suwarun is the plural for suratun, with suratun is sword. And hadihi darrajatu, darrajatu is a bicycle. That this bicycle that has al ajali, means al ajali is the wheels. So if you see, is al thalathi is against nath, so it has three wheels. See al ajali al thalathi libni, see libni, it is for li ibni, because it is hamzatul wasl and ibnun. We know Ibnun and Ismun, they have Hamzatul Wasl, so that is not pronounced, so it is a Libni. So how many words here? Li, Ibnun and Ya Mutakallim, the three words in Libni. So belongs to my son. And what is As-Saghiri? As-Saghiri is Nath for the son, so belongs to my small or younger son. Tilkal Imaratu. So that building, imaratun is building. Zatun nawafidul kabira, that has nawafid is windows. Al kabirati, why al kabirati? Nawafid is plural, so it's treated as a single feminine. Kullu jamamannas, so if it is a feminine, it's al kabirati, that's why it is al kabirati. Zatun nawafidul kabirati masrif. Masrif means bank. So that building which has big windows is a bank. So masriful is your khabar, one word. So again here, so we have to understand tilka is mubtada, al masjidu is badal tilka al masjidu, and dhatu is coming as a naat for masjidu, which has, and after dhatu is mudaf ilayhi al manairu, that is the minarets. Al-Aliyah, Aliyah means high, that has high minarets. So the whole thing becomes as a part of Mubtada. And what is your khabar is Jamilatun, it's beautiful. And what is Jiddan, that is Maful al-Mutlaq, which is very. So that masjid that has tall minarets, what about that? It is very beautiful. So this is how we use. So what we're going to do today is we're also going to quickly cover lesson number 8, which is a very very easy lesson. We already very much familiar with this. So basically what Dr. Ibrahim is teaching us, the use of verb which is dhahaba in all the forms except duals, to identify the fail and fa'il. For example, if you say hamidun dhahaba, and in that's more from the jama'u, so hamidun wa hashimun wa aliyun dhahabu. So here, because the waw represents the jama'u, so we use a proper fa'al. So we know aminatu, we know it is dhahabat, and aminatu wa zainabu wa maryamu, so we know hunna, that is dhahabna. كنا ذهبنا أنت ذهبت أنتم ذهبتم أنت ذهبتي أنتن ذهبتن أنا ذهبت نحن ذهبنا. So we are very much familiar with this. So we can also do the duals. We can do the full 14 conjugations. ذهب حامد ذهب. ذهب means ألف مثنى dual. ذهبوا هم ذهبوا ذهبت ذهبتا ذهبنا ذهبتا ذهبتما ذهبتم ذهبتي ذهبتما ذهبتن ذهبت ذهبنا. So we know what is فعل and what is فاعل. So just going to figure out in few of the exercises here. So just depending on the sentence we have to use a proper فعل. So we say أين الطلاب. It should be, it's a type of error here, it says الجدد. So where are the new students? الجدد is not for طلاب, it has to be plural, it has to match. So what noun do we, what verb do we use? So we use, so it's plural, so we use plural verb and it represents, wow represents whom we say ذهبوا. طلابوا is ذهبوا, again it's a type of here. ذهبوا إلى مديري. نحن ذهبنا. نحن ذهبنا إلى الملعب. So we went to the playground. أين أين, so we have to use a fail for بعد الدرس يا إخواني. See إخواني is يا means حرف نداء, it is in front of you. So إخواني is brothers, is plural male. So it is أين ذهبتم. Again, there's a type of error here. It is ذهبتم because it is the second person in front of you. Well, because it is حرف نداء. So again, يا is coming. يا أبي. So a something. إلى السوق اليوم. اليوم يا أبي ذهبت. Did you go to السوق today, oh my father? أنا ما. So something is what is أنا means ذهبت. أنا ما ذهبت إلى المكتبة. إلى المكتبة اليوم. So I did not go to the library today. So we do few more exercises so we get more stronger inshallah. So we say أمي is again two words مضاف إليه أمي plus يا متكلم. So because it is أمي is feminine we use ذهبت. أمي ذهبت إلى المستشفى. So we say يا بناتي. See يا is again in front of you. Because it's banati is plural feminine, so we say a ذهبتن. ذهبتن لزيارة خالاتكن. خالاتكن is مضاف إليه ضمير متصل. So كاكما كم كيكما كن يا بناتي. Did you all go to visit your aunt? Yeah. Oh my daughters. Again, أخي إلى المطار. So you're asking in front of no, أخي means my brother. So you're telling ذهب. ذهب أخي إلى المطار. So أخواتي. What is أخواتي? It's آتي means sisters. My sisters are two words. My sisters. So what do you say about my sisters? The third person you're talking about them is ذهبنا. هن ذهبنا إلى كلية. كلية means to department. كلية means department. So again يا عائشة means in front of you. عائشة, so that is feminine. So to use first feminine أ ذهبتي. أ ذهبتي إلى المدرسة يا عائشة. So that is our end of the lesson inshallah. So we are very much, it's a very easy simple lesson just to give us a practice, a revision of where to use under what sentence depending on the being addressed to which type of فعل and فاعل, how do we identify. So inshallah we'll start a new concept from our next lesson. So until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.